Okay guys, the new topic is Gibbs free energy. This relationship enables to us estimate whether a reaction occurs spontaneous or not. You know what is a spontaneous reaction? So this relationship used for determine the reaction is spontaneous or not. The symbol of this function is G. It defines the maximum energy which can be obtained from measurement of delta H and delta S. Okay, we will use delta H and delta S here to calculate the delta G. So temperature and pressure also important here. Relation should be at the constant temperature and pressure. It's a real function which shows if physical change or chemical reaction occurs spontaneously or not. By this way, we can determine the physical change or chemical reaction spontaneous or not. If value of delta G is negative, reaction or physical change occurs spontaneously. If the delta G is negative, the process is spontaneous process. If value of delta G is positive, it is not spontaneous. It does not occur spontaneously. If the value of delta G is zero, reaction or physical change at equilibrium. It means neither spontaneous nor not spontaneous. The system at the equilibrium. You can say like that. Standard Gibbs free energy of reaction. You know, the calculation of delta H, the relationship is same here, like calculation of delta H of reaction. It is shown with delta H reaction symbol, okay, because we are talking about standard Gibbs free energy of reaction. Okay? So, its symbol is delta G reaction. And in order to calculate delta G reaction, for any reaction, value standard Gibbs free energy of formation are used. So we have to know the delta H, delta G of formation, standard delta G of formation of the reactants and products, all components of the reaction. So to calculate the delta G are total mole of delta GF products minus total mole delta GF reactants. N is number of moles which we said in the calculation of enthalpy also. And this sign is also, it means total. A times A, B times B to form G times G, H times H. The change of standard free Gibbs energy of this reaction is as follows. We can make the relationship between the formation of reactants and products to get the delta G of reaction. Delta G of reaction is equal to G times GF plus G times GF, G plus H times H plus minus A times A plus B times B. Here, and there is one information here, important information here. Like delta H of formation of elements is zero. Here also, delta G of formation of element is zero. Unit of standard free energy is joule over mole according to the international system of units. There is an example here. Calculate standard Gibbs free energy of the following reaction under standard condition 25 and 1 atmosphere pressure. Also tell if the reaction occurs spontaneously or not under this condition. We said that if the value is minus, delta G is minus, the process should be spontaneously, okay? So benzene plus oxygen to form carbon dioxide and water is given here. And there are some givens. Delta G of formation, standard delta G of formation of benzene, and standard delta G formation of carbon dioxide and water given here. To get the delta G of reaction, we have to take the sum of the products and sum of the reactant. We have to subtract the reactant total values of reactants from products. So 12 times of carbon dioxide, which is in the reaction, you know, it is at the product side, 12 times of carbon dioxide delta GF plus 6 times delta GF of water minus 2 times of benzene, because in the reactant side we have 2 times of benzene plus 15 times of oxygen. So 12 times of minus 394 plus 6 times of minus 2, 37. From here we can get the result like that, minus 6,496 kilojoule per mole. It is the standard delta G of reaction. So the sign is minus here, negative, result is negative. So reaction is spontaneous reaction. Reaction occurs spontaneously. Calculate standard Gibbs free energy of the following reaction under standard conditions, and also tell if the reaction occurs spontaneously or not under these conditions. Firstly, we have to calculate the delta G of the reaction. Delta G reaction is equal to the total mole of delta GF of products minus total number of mole delta GF, standard delta GF of reactant. Okay, so from here delta G reaction is equal to nitrogen dioxide we have here. So 2 times nitrogen dioxide, value of nitrogen dioxide is 52 kilojoule per mole. Okay, minus, it is product side, minus how many times of nitrogen monoxide we have? 2 times, and it is value is 87 kilojoule per mole, plus oxygen, 1 time of oxygen, and oxygen is 0, as you know, because it is in the most stable form. It is in the gas state because it is written here G. Okay, so from here delta GR is equal to minus 70 kilojoule per mole, and process is spontaneous process. Why the process is spontaneous process? Because the result is negative, so we can say the process is spontaneous process. Application of Gibbs equation and direction of chemical reactions. According to Gibbs equation, change in free energy include two important factors which affect if chemical reaction can occur spontaneously or not. There are two factors here. The first factor is delta H factor, second one is delta S factor. Okay, the first factor is the reaction mostly work toward the direction with the lowest energy. If value of delta H is negative, in other words, exothermic, okay, if the delta H is negative, it means it is exothermic, the possibility of the spontaneous occurrence of reaction is increased. If the delta H is negative, possibility of the spontaneous being spontaneous process is increased. Okay, so because the result should be minus to be spontaneous process, right? Second factor, reaction mostly work toward the direction with the highest entropy. I said The first one is enthalpy, second one is entropy. Entropy is delta S, you know. If values delta is positive, if disorder, in other words, disorder increase, the possibility of spontaneous occurrence in reaction also increase. Okay? If it is plus, minus time plus is minus. So the possibility of the spontaneous should be increase, okay, in this condition. If you put aside temperature, there must be a relationship as follows between two factors mentioned. If the delta H is smaller than zero, so the possibility of the spontaneous process is increased. If the delta S bigger than zero, the possibility of the spontaneous process will be increased. There are four important way to be spontaneous process. Generally, delta S and delta H and delta S symbols affect values of delta G in four ways. If delta H and delta S have positive values, then delta T delta S is bigger than delta H, delta G will be negative. Imagine that delta G is equal to delta H minus T delta S. If the delta H and delta S have positive values, positive, okay, then T delta S is bigger than delta H, if the T delta S is bigger than delta H, so overall result should be minus, so the process will be spontaneous, okay? This condition occurs when T is high. If the T high here, if the temperature is high here, so the totally T delta S should be bigger than delta H in this condition. In the second one, delta H is positive and delta S is negative. Value delta G will be always positive. Why? Because delta H is positive, it is positive, and delta S is negative. Negative time negative are positive, so result should be positive, okay? So it is not spontaneous. If value of delta G, delta H is negative and delta S is positive, value delta G will be negative independent of the effect of temperature. If the value of delta H is negative and delta S is positive, okay? Because minus time plus will be minus, and it is, if the delta H already negative, so overall result should be negative. If both values delta H and delta S are negative, and if value T delta S is less than delta H, value of delta G will be negative. Of course, it should be negative because both of them are negative. Both of them are negative, and it is less than delta H. If it is less than delta H, overall should be negative. So it is spontaneous process. Okay, there is a diagram here to understand the process better. Plus plus delta H and delta S. If the delta H and delta S plus, reaction occurs spontaneously at high temperature. It occurs spontaneously in the opposite direction of low temperatures. Delta H is positive and delta S is negative. Delta G always positive because, you know, we said that in the previous page. Reaction does not occur spontaneously at all temperature. In all ways, it should be positive. If delta H is negative and delta S is positive, delta G is always negative. Reaction occurs spontaneously at all temperature. And if both of them are negative, reaction occurs spontaneously at low temperatures. So we said that for what? Okay, there is an example here, example 112. In this example, you will see all the calculations of delta HR, delta SR, delta GR. We talked about the calculation of delta HR in the previous lesson, okay? And firstly, calculate the following values for the reaction under standard conditions. By using these values, we can get the delta HR, delta SR, delta GR. Firstly, we have to take the sum of the products of delta HF and sum of the reactants, okay? We can get the delta HR from here, 2 moles of carbon dioxide in the first reaction, okay? And 3 moles of water produced from the reaction, and 1 mole of ethyl alcohol burned with 3 moles of oxygen, and we can get the result like that. Delta SR is equal to total S products, total mole number of S reactants. It's equal to 2 times of S carbon dioxide and 3 times of water also in the same reaction. So 1 mole of ethyl alcohol and 3 moles of oxygen. And all of them are given, 2 times of 214 plus 3 times of 70 minus 161 and plus 3 times of 205. We have to calculate it to the kilojoule. To calculate the joule to kilojoule, we have to multiply it 1 over 1000. So we can get the result of delta SR here. Calculation of delta GR. How can we calculate the delta GR here? Firstly, we should get the delta HR and delta SR. After that, we can calculate the delta GR, okay? So we can write the delta GR like that. Delta GR is equal to minus 1,368 kilojoule per mole minus and minus 0.138 kilojoule per Kelvin time mole times 298 Kelvin. So you know how can we calculate it? So the result is minus 1,327 kilojoule per mole. So it is delta GR. Calculate the value of delta GR of the following reaction under standard conditions. And reaction is given here. It is pentane. It is pentane. Pentane plus oxygen to form carbon dioxide and water. Under standard conditions, the value of enthalpy of reaction delta HR was calculated and following result was obtained. Delta HR is given here, okay? And beside delta SR was calculated and the following result obtained, delta SR also given here. So we have to calculate the delta GR here. To calculate the delta GR, it's equal to delta HR, standard delta HR minus T standard delta SR, okay? So from here, delta GR is equal to, what is the delta HR? It is given in kilojoule, minus 3,536 minus, firstly we have to get the temperature in Kelvin, 25 Celsius is equal to 298 Kelvin, as you know, minus. So delta SR is given in the joule. So we have to convert it to kilojoule. Delta SR is equal to 374 joule over K time mole times 1 over 1000, and we can get 0.374 kilo joule over k mol. Okay. So here the temperature is 298 Kelvin times 0.374. From here, result should be minus 3647.5 kilojoule per mole, and process is spontaneous. Spontaneous process. Why is it spontaneous? Because it is negative. The result is negative. There is another exercise here. Calculate the value of change in free energy of the following reaction under standard condition. So we have to calculate the change in standard free energy of the following reaction. It means delta G of reaction. We have to calculate the delta G of reaction here also. What are given here? Delta S are given and delta H are given. So it is possible to calculate the delta G R here. Delta H R minus T delta S R. Firstly, we have to calculate the, we can write delta H R directly because it's in the kilojoule. 16 minus what is T? T is given here, 25 Celsius. It means 298 Kelvin times delta S also given here, but in joule, we have to convert it to kilojoule. Delta SR is equal to, you can write directly 0.234 kilojoule per K time mol. Okay. So 0.234 from here you can get the result delta GR is equal to minus 53.7 kilojoule per mol. So process is also spontaneous because the okay, the value is negative here. Finally, the final topic of the chapter 1 is calculation of entropies of physical changes. Okay. In the previous chapters, in the previous topics, actually, we have defined standard enthalpies of physical change and enthalpy of vaporization. We talked about the enthalpy of vaporization. Enthalpy change of vaporization or melting point, melting processes, delta H fusion, delta H vaporization, delta H crystallization, you know. So besides, we know that substances change from solid to liquid at melting temperature, TM, you know, TM is the melting temperature, and substance can pass to gas state from liquid. It is boiling process, and TB is boiling temperature. Okay, melting and boiling temperatures are at equilibrium between solid or liquid vapor and atmospheric pressure. You know, you should know from also a physics lesson and other topics. Melting and boiling temperatures are at equilibrium between solid and okay, we talked about the delta H fusion, delta H vaporization, TM, you know, the melting temperature and boiling temperature, okay. And we said here melting and boiling temperature are at equilibrium between solid or liquid vapor and atmospheric pressure, okay. It means, that means value of delta G at these temperatures is equal to zero. We said delta G of the transition process are zero, okay? Delta G of these temperatures is equal to zero. So from here we can get the calculation of delta STR, calculation of entropies, okay? Because the topic is calculation of entropies of physical changes. You know, there are two types of processes, physical change and chemical change. We are calculating here physical change entropies. So we can get the physical change entropies from the equation, from this equation, okay? Delta G is equal to delta H minus T delta S. If the delta G is zero for transition processes, transition process means melting, işte boiling or crystallization, fusion processes, okay? So delta is TR. So delta is fusion. If we talk about the delta S fusion, delta S fusion is equal to delta H fusion over TM. Why TM? TM means melting. Fusion means also melting, like melting. Delta S vaporization. Vaporization means, you know, the evaporation process is equal to delta H vaporization over TB. Why B? B means boiling, okay? Boiling and vaporization almost same, not same actually, but almost same processes. So there is a rule here which we use in the questions, Truton's rule. Truton's rule. A scientist called Truton found out that the values of delta S of most liquids is equal to constant number 85 joule over K time mole. Therefore, the final equation can be rearranged as follows. Delta S vaporization is equal to 85 joule over K time mole. It is constant number. This constant number can be used for to calculate TB or VAP, okay? Delta H vaporization, okay? So if we know the TB, we can calculate the delta H vaporization. So next question, you will see how can we use the formula. There is an example here. As the boiling point of hexane is 69 Celsius, calculate the enthalpy of vaporization, delta H vaporization in kilojoule in mole units. Firstly, we have to convert the Celsius to Kelvin. Okay. And the Kelvin is, temperature is in Kelvin, 342 Kelvin. Delta S vaporization is equal to delta H vaporization over TB. It is equal to 85 joule over K time mole. And we have to get the delta H vaporization. It is asked in the question to calculate, okay? So delta H vaporization is equal to 85 joule over K time mole times TB. TB, we calculate the TB like 342. So result is 29,070 joule over mole. And we can calculate the value in kilojoule. For that we have to multiply the value by 1 over 1000, as you know, and we can get the result. Result is 29 kilojoule per mole. Calculate change of entropy for water boiling at 100 Celsius. It is boiling point, and we said that we can calculate the enthalpy or entropy by using this formula, okay? Firstly, to calculate the to solve the question, we have to calculate firstly Kelvin. To Kelvin, you know, T Celsius plus 273 is equal to 373 Kelvin, the boiling point of the water. And we have to write the equation first. Delta S vaporization is equal to delta H vaporization over TB. Delta H vaporization is given here, 44. And we know what is the boiling point, 373 Kelvin. So we have to write the units also, kilojoule per mole over Kelvin, okay? So from here, the result is 0.118 kilojoule per K time mole, and it's also equal to 118 joule over K time mole.